Hello and welcome to a very different looking news review. Like millions of other people around the world, we are working from home. We are not able to get into our studios to record news review and our other programs as normal because of the coronavirus outbreak. But we are still going to bring you headlines and teach you vocabulary around them. I am joined, but not next to me, in a different part of London, by Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Neil. Hello, everybody, wherever you are. Yes, we're working from home. We're bringing you news review as normal, and today we're going to be looking at vocabulary around mental health issues around coronavirus.
Okay, well, let's hear a report from BBC News about that story.
More than 8 million people in the UK suffer from anxiety disorders, but the current concerns over the spread of the coronavirus and the restrictions on daily life have left many more people feeling under pressure. Anxiety UK estimates it's seen a rise of between 30 and 35% in the number of calls to its helpline in the last couple of weeks. The charity recommends that to reduce anxiety, people talk about their concerns, limit the time they spend listening to the latest developments, and find time to do things that distract them.
So, we're living in very uncertain times. Now, medical health professionals are saying that the stress that this is causing at the moment may have an impact on people with existing mental health conditions and may have an effect on people who otherwise don't really experience too much stress.
Okay, well, you've been looking around the world's media at this story and you've picked out three words and expressions. What have you got?
Yes, we have anxiety, isolation and taking a toll.
Anxiety, isolation and taking a toll. So your first headline then with that word anxiety, please.
And we'll start with the BBC from the UK news website. The headline is Coping with Coronavirus Anxiety.
Anxiety, a strong feeling of worry.
Yes, anxiety, spelt A-N-X-I-E-T-Y. Now, the first thing to talk about is pronunciation and how do you say that X in the middle of the word? Well, it's ngs. Ngs. Neil, can you give me your ngs?
Yes, it's that ng sound that we have in ing, I-N-G. It's like singing. So ing, and then there's a z sound after anxiety.
Anxiety. Now, there's a four-syllable word. There's four syllables in this word. Anxiety. Anxiety. The stress is on the I. Anxiety. Give us it again, Neil, please.
Anxiety.
Perfect pronunciation.
Thank you.
So anxiety is essentially a feeling of worry, but it's a strong feeling of worry. So it's not the kind of worry where you go to work and you think, oh, did I remember to feed the cat? It's more like really like, I haven't seen the cat for days. Where on earth is she? Ah, it's a kind of worry that really kind of interferes with your everyday life. Some people have so much anxiety that they can't really live. It's really difficult for them to live normally. And this is when it becomes a kind of mental health condition. So we all have a bit of anxiety, but when worry gets really, really strong and it interferes with your life, that's anxiety.
Now, the word anxiety is a noun, but in its adjective form, anxious, there is more of a crossover between worried and anxious, isn't there, than worry and anxiety?
Yes, it's more similar. You can say, I'm worried about the cat, I'm anxious about the cat. And it really means just general worry. So to be anxious and to worry are fairly similar, but anxiety is much more of a medical condition. And that's what these headlines are focusing on. That idea of worrying so much that your life stops being normal and pleasant.
And what are the words often used around this word, anxious and anxiety?
Well, you can be anxious about something. You can have anxiety. You can be anxious. And it's always usually about is when you add on what is making you feel anxious or have anxiety.
And we often hear the expression anxiety attack. What's that?
Yes, anxiety. And an anxiety attack is also known as a panic attack. And again, that's an experience where You might feel very sweaty, your palms of your hands are sweaty, you feel panicky, you can't breathe, you feel everything spinning like you're going to faint. It's a really quite terrifying experience. So an anxiety attack it can be a few minutes, it can go on for quite a long time. And again, if you find yourself having an anxiety or a panic attack, it is what happens. Sometimes you need medical help, but it's a serious state of heightened worry, which is quite scary.
Okay, well, we hope nobody has to go through something like that. Let's now have a summary. Okay, now let's have a look at that second headline, please, Catherine.
Yes, we're now going to ITV News in the UK. The headline is Isolation, Anxiety and Coronavirus. Plea to protect mental health during pandemic.
Isolation, the state of being alone.
Yes, I-S-O-L-A-T-I-O-N. Isolation. Say it for me, Neil, and we'll try and work out the stress.
Isolation.
There are four syllables. Isolation. One more demo, please, for the stress, please, Neil.
Isolation.
Hope you heard it that time. The stress is on the third syllable. Isolation. Isolation.
There's a little clue, isn't there, in this word about what it means, that bit, that solo bit.
Solo, yeah, the sol bit, sol or solo. If you speak a Latin language, you will know solo has an idea of being alone, S-O-L-O. And the sol in isolation tells you that. So if you are in isolation, and the preposition is in, or if you go into isolation, you are alone. You become alone for a period of time. Now, there is a difference between just going into the bedroom for 20 minutes because you want a bit of peace and quiet and being in isolation. If you're in isolation, it's usually there's for a longer period of time and often because you have to for some reason. If you're in hospital with an infectious disease, you may go into an isolation ward or an isolation room. Now, with coronavirus, a lot of people are going into self-isolation. If you're in self-isolation, or if you self-isolate, which is the verb form, it means you decide yourself to stay alone by yourself, or you decide to stay alone at your own home because you've been advised to by the authorities.
And we wish everybody well who is in isolation at the moment. Let's now take a look at a summary. If you would like to watch a video about how people are keeping themselves happy and entertained while they're in isolation, we have one, which you can find where, Catherine?
By clicking the link in the description. Do watch it. There's quite a few famous people showing you how to not get bored during isolation. It's fun.
Are we allowed to mention Madonna and Lionel Messi?
Well, you just did. So that's that.
Okay, time now for our third headline.
Yes, so over to the United States now. The website is The Verge, and the headline, COVID-19 anxiety taking a toll. There's a subreddit for that.
Taking a toll, causing harm over time.
Yes, now we've got a three-word phrase today. Taking a toll. Taking, T-A-K-I-N-G. A is spelt a. Toll, or toll, as some people pronounce it, is T-O-L-L. So the phrase, taking a toll.
Now, I know what a toll is. A toll is a sort of payment you have to make to drive on a certain road. What has this got to do with our story?
So let's just talk about tolls when you're driving. If you drive along some roads in the UK, you have, or in a lot of countries, you have to pay some money to use that road, don't you, Neil?
You do, yes.
And that road is called?
It's called a toll road.
And the place where you pay is?
A toll booth.
Very good. Third question. And the money that you pay is?
A toll.
So a toll is essentially a payment. Now, in the road example, you pay your money, you pay the toll and you get a benefit. But this is kind of reversed. It's actually a price you pay when something, in a bad way, you get not a benefit, it's a kind of cost that you pay and you don't really get anything back. Now, let's have a look at, Neil, your lifestyle. I believe you're fond of a nightclub.
Well, I used to be.
And you used to nightclub quite often, didn't you?
Well, you know, once or twice, a day.
Yes. And we all knew when you were doing it, Neil, because you would come into work and you looked awful, to be honest. Your face was grey, your eyes were red, you would kind of fall asleep at your desk in the afternoon, your work was suffering. Remember?
Yes, those are the days.
And we knew because all that nightclubbing was taking a toll on your health and especially your appearance. So you can't deny it, Neil. We've got the photographs anyway.
It was a bad time.
Well, those were the days, like you say. Anyway, so your bad appearance was your nightclubbing taking a toll. Nightclubbing took a toll on your health. COVID-19 is taking a toll on people's mental health. It means it's having a bad effect on something.
Thank you for that. Now let's have a summary slide. Okay, time now for a recap of the vocabulary we've looked at in this programme, Catherine.
Yes, we had anxiety, a feeling of worry. Isolation, the state of being alone. And taking a toll, causing harm over time.
If you would like to test yourself on this vocabulary, you can go to our website where there's a quiz and all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. We do hope you stay safe, and we will be in our homes again next week and probably the week after and the week after that. Take care, everybody, and goodbye.
Stay safe. Bye.